shit, I did it! Yes, finally!
Oh my god.
Holy shit, I finally killed him! Holy fuck, that took forever.
Hey everybody, this is Jeff here with N Video Games for another episode of Let's Play ActRaiser on the Super Nintendo. We left off in Aitos, however the heck you say that. And we're going to be finishing that up, and then we're going to be moving on to Marahna, I think that's how you say it. Yeah, Marahna maybe? I don't know. And then after that, we're going to do Northwall if we have time. Or parts of Northwall, probably. We probably won't be able to finish it in an hour, but we'll see how it goes. So let's get started and check it out. So I already loaded up my save game here in Aitos. If you recall, I did a little bit of this on my last episode of ActRaiser. So we're going over here to steal this blue dragon lair is where we're going. That's our last monster lair, it looks like. So we're just gonna hang out up here and wait for them to finish building, basically. Yeah, build the road all the way up there. And make sure I kill the blue dragons as they come out. People wanna talk to me. My master, we've learned to make clothes from the fleece of our sheep. This fleece is very warm and can be very useful to any land as cold as Aitos. This year, may we present this fleece as an offering. Probably gonna need that for Northwall, because that's a cold area. Let's see, take the offering here. Oops, wrong button. Stop moving! I hate when they dodge my attacks like that, it's very annoying. B3 and B is to B's to progress, because most games A is to progress, which is strange. My master, this is the sheep's fleece. If you use its wool to make clothes, even people in cold climates can live comfortably. Got an arrow upgrade, strength of an angel. And I had the bomb, which is the kill all flying monsters thing. This is probably the best place to stay for this particular one. Until he decides to do this nonsense and move on me. Looks like one or two more should be good for us to get this closed. There you go. Bye bye, blue dragon lair. Talk to me again. Oh, master, please save us. The old dormant volcano has suddenly erupted. We can hear monsters' footsteps. Our town, Aitos, will not only be destroyed by the eruption, but also by monsters. Please come down and fight for us and the men who have given their lives in sealing the monster's lair. There's a volcano that mentioned. And the people naturally are freaking out about that. I'm gonna burn these bushes here first. I can't remember if there's any magic available on this map or not. Oh yeah, they're building in the town when there's a volcano erupting. That makes a lot of sense. Brilliant. Okay. Let's return to the Sky Palace here and go down and fight. What? You're not quitting, are you? I meant to do select magic. I don't know which one I need. What we'll do is Stardust. Alright, now we're ready to fight. Aitos, Act 2 coming up. Our Mode 7 rotation into the volcano, which magically has suddenly stopped erupting. I guess if it was erupting when you went in, it would probably not be very good, but... Alright, here we go. Well, we can't go right, so I guess we gotta go left. Stupid gargoyle. We got these rock things that come out of the lava here. Kind of like exploding potaboos from Mario. Now, you'd think you couldn't go past this thing right here, this pillar, but you can. It's just part of the foreground. And that cloud is chasing me all over the place. Great, gone that one. You need to leave me alone. Go away, clouds. Getting jacked up here, man. This is not very good. There we go. Oh, jumped in the lava. That was not very smart. I was trying to jump backwards, and that did not work. Clearly. Guess that's what you're supposed to do for those exploding guys, is to jump back. There we go. First I thought you couldn't kill those other pieces of cloud, but you can. Almost not me in the lava. Sure, don't be doing that. I almost jumped right into that one. That would have been bad. Alright, next section. Ugh, more of these damn clouds. Hate these things. So anytime you want to hit the cloud, it would be nice. You know, what a concept. Well, that sucked. Didn't know that went all the way down to lava. Really, start me back at the beginning of the level? You couldn't start me back there? That's garbage. Stupid clouds, hate the clouds. There you go. Stop hitting me. That is not cool. Not cool, game. Not cool. Surprised I didn't count as a death there. I was right close to the lava. The lower ones go in the lava. That's how it works there. That particular part. Oh. Exploding guy. You got a card shooting out arrows here. Also two. Another cloud. More exploding rock things. Several more guards here. Samurai guards of arrows. I guess they're samurais, so kind of like samurais. Could use some health here. Hey, this is health. Nope, source of magic. We preferred health, but okay. Take out the cloud. I got some fire thing here. And jump on top of them. Got another orb pillar here. That was an apple. Oops. Got hit on my way down. Alright, here's the boss. Looks like Stardust is a good choice for this boss. So by the way, I don't know if I mentioned this before, but while you're using magic, like Stardust for example, you're immune to damage. Bosses went right through me, as you saw there. I didn't get hit once by him. Pretty simple boss. I just used Stardust like 3 times and killed him. We finished the level 1,360 points. Or 13,000 rather. 560 points. People want to talk to me again. Oh, Master, all the monsters in Aitos have been destroyed. Thank you for taking care of us. We can now take care of ourselves. So please help Otherlands enjoy the peace we have here in Aitos. We're gonna finish building it up here and then leave after we're done with that. Get some more rocks we could clear out here. One more after that one. This one right here is where we gotta go. Use lightning again. Clear the rocks. There we go, all the rocks are gone. Bushes are gone. I'm gonna just wait for the people to populate. Come on, people. There we go. Go, 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 people. Got a level. Alright. We're now level 11 and have 18 hit points. We'll level again when we get 2,500 people total. So, Aitos has ranches and windmills as well. People want to talk to me again. My master, we have now refined our mountaineer skills. The mountains hold many unseen mysteries. We will inform you if anything is discovered. That might be a magic thing that they're talking about. There's the guy on the mountain. Walking around like it's no big deal. That's pretty funny. Hurry up. Alright. Okay, so our building direction here again. There we go. I went up that way, right above me, to finish the road there. People won't talk to me again. My master, we have found a scroll in the mountains northeast of here. Probably a magic offering, source of magic, rather. Yep, source of magic. Thanks guys for the source of magic. Which, as I mentioned before, you have to have sources of magic to be able to use your magical spells. If you don't have any, you can't use them. They get restored after every level, though, once you complete a level. The ones you have previously collected. Which is nice. That's only applicable for the action scenes, the platforming scenes. For the simulation scenes like this, you use SP, which you see in the top right of the screen. We need to set a build direction here. Forgot to do that. Once this is done constructing, I'll do that. Since I can't trigger the menu while it's constructing. Go. I think that's the last road we can build. Can't go up this way, I don't think. There's some mountains in the way. Same with that. Can't go down here because mountains in the way again. Might be able to do it. Oh, I already did that. Okay, never mind. I'll try one more here, see if I can go anywhere. Oh, I can go down here. I didn't think I could. Give Get me up to 2500 so I level again. That'd be cool. It's pretty funny how it's on top of the mountain there. Anytime. I like how the sheep or goat or one of those disappears while the town's under construction. It's kind of funny. And magically it reappears after we're done. See? Weird. Very strange. Almost to 2500. This should do it right here. Been another level for us. Yep. We're now level 12 and we have 19 hit points. We're getting in another level and we can have 2900 people total. Let's check the build direction here again. I want to make sure I'm not forgetting anything. I don't think I am, but I want to double check just to make sure. Yeah, I can't go any further directions there, so that's it for Aitos. No more offerings available, so we are done here. I'll go to Marahna, or Marahna, however you say that, which is down to the south here. It's the island place, I do believe. Yep, this is it right here. Or several islands, I should say. Apparently Stardust equipped, because I don't know which one to use, so that's a little bit better when you don't know what you're doing, or don't know which one to use, I should say. Alright, so here we go, Marahna Act 1, coming up. May luck be with you. Luck? I don't need luck, I got skill. This is a swamp, jungle kind of area. Kind of like, I guess they're supposed to be Native Americans or natives. Not necessarily Native American, but just natives in general. Turn around! I don't know why I kept sitting there swinging the sword. I was turning around and it wasn't doing anything. So unlike most of the liquid areas of the game, you can actually jump in this. It's like a swamp water kind of thing. It doesn't kill you when you do. Which is nice, I guess. Some parts you have to do it, so I mean, it's kind of unavoidable. Jumping statue thing. There's one below us that shoots arrows. And after several hits, some birds. There's an arrow shooting one. The air shooting one towards the left here. Alright, there's two of them. Didn't want to jump into them, but okay. How is that not hitting them? It's like going right through them and it's not counting. That's garbage. Now I can't get back up there either. That really sucks. Unless I die. I didn't know that was the case. Got some spear-toting guy here. He's jacking us up really bad. Next section. Another puddle enemy, for lack of a better description. Blob thing, whatever the hell it's supposed to be. More natives. There are blow darts. Something back over here to the left, but I don't think we can get over there. Another native throwing a bomb at me. Can't jump on that. Really, dude? Knock me down in here. Oh, well, at least there's an apple down there. A full apple, not a partial one. That's nice. Well, there are these spear guys again. Some snakes. Another spear guy. More snakes. Alright, well, next section. It's boss time. Already. Look at that. It's this plant thing. Fire probably would have been better for this. I don't know, maybe I was just too close to him. Doesn't seem to be hitting very much with Stardust. And I've used all my Stardust, I don't have any more available. So now I've got to melee him. Not that difficult. Spam your magic on him. Magic is ridiculously overpowered in the platforming sections. Alright, so here's the simulation portion of Marahna. Or Marahna, however you say it. I'm gonna go with Marahna, that sounds better. I think. They want to talk to me, of course, because they always want to talk as soon as you start, basically. Oh, Master, although a beautiful island, Marahna is covered with palm trees and seems so small. Would you destroy some of the palm trees? The blue dragon, red dragon. Alright, we're gonna use an offering here. Use strength of angel. Got some bat. So, I think lightning will destroy the palm trees, if I remember correctly. Yep. That was right. Come on, let me set my build direction. So this blue dragon layer here. Not sure how I'm supposed to get to the red one. It's across the water there. Unless I can send a ship over there or something. Or maybe I get one of the item seal things. Or the sealing items, I should say. Which I got before when I had that skull, I believe. I think that's what it is, like a skull or something like that. I forget what it is exactly, but I know there is one. Alright, so on the blue dragon layer. Oh, wait, bat. Where's the bat? There's some swamp stuff there. They found something in the monster's lair. Let's see what that was. My master, we have found a strange bow and some arrows. We present this to you as an offering. Please accept it. That's strength of an angel, of course. Now they want to talk to me again. My master, we would like to extend our town to the island northwest of here. Is there any way to make the channel and the island into a part of a continent? So to clear out this, swamp stuff, marshlands, I guess is technically what the game calls it. We gotta use sunlight, of course. There's some more palm trees we gotta destroy over here. There's another blue dragon over here. Got a swampland to dry up here, marshland. God, I keep calling it swamp. Marshland. I don't know why I keep calling it swamp. And there's palm trees in the way as well that we have to knock down before we conceal the lair. Alright, we've got a clear path to the blue dragon lair here. So we're going to go try to seal it. Check on this red dragon over here. Angel's power is no more. People want to talk to me. Oh, Master, a temple has suddenly appeared in Marahna. People are saying they built it to worship you, but I sense something is wrong. The temple is the only building the monsters have not tried to destroy. That makes me very uneasy. I hope nothing happens. And get the Strength of the Angel Harem again so I can use it again. Comes in handy on this particular mission because you got all these dragons to deal with. And they're gonna cause problems for our people if we don't take care of them before the layers get sealed. Oh, the bat almost grabbed somebody. The bats will kidnap your people. People won't talk to me again. Many of our people have already turned against our Eternal Master. I believe the shrine may be the cause of this change of heart. This is a problem we must solve on our own. I just thought you should know. There we go. Blue Dragon Lair is getting sealed. And there's a shrine they were talking about. Seal the Blue Dragon Lair. And they found something out. My master, we have found a strange statue. We present this to you as an offering. Please accept it. That's a bomb, of course. Got some palm trees in the way we gotta take care of here. Another red dragon, another bat. Where'd the bat go? There he is. Gonna set our build direction here so we can go down and seal this bat layer. I forgot to drop the swampland there, so I gotta do that. Marshland! God! Why the hell do I keep calling it swampland? Marshland. I think I might need bridge building. I don't think I have that. I gotta go back to whatchamacallit to get that probably. But I'll wait and see. They might be able to do it on their own. Don't know. Oh, there was already a bat up. I was like, why is the bat not spawning? Alright, got a few more before we can get over to the bat layer. Angel's powers no more. I hate these red dragons, they're very annoying. They take like 5 or 6 hits. People won't talk to me again. Oh, Master, because of the many plagues here in Marahna, we should never be without medical herbs. May we present this herb as an offering to you this year. If any other lands suffer from their own plagues as we do, please offer this herb to them. So they build farms in Marahna, as you can see. Oh, they do have bridges already. Nice. Don't have to worry about that, then. So the bat layer's gone. Sir Jeff, I believe the final monster's lair must be located on the island northwest here. Yeah, you think? Is there any way to raise the continent and connect the two together? Well, there is. It's a one of our powers we haven't used yet. Earthquake. Boom. Some change may take place to the continent if you cause an earthquake. Do you want to create an earthquake? Yes. So this will destroy some of my houses too. But I had to do it. I don't have a choice. I mean, that's how you have to progress in this this particular area. Sir Jeff, look, something strange is about to happen near the northwestern shore. See, that connects it. How wonderful, the two islands are now connected. So that wiped out like all my people, practically. I mean, look at that. All the houses are destroyed. All the farms are destroyed. There's like nobody here. But, like I said, I didn't have a choice in the matter. I had to do it. If I had to remember to do that, I would have done it before I sealed the other ones off. But I couldn't remember that. That's okay, though, because everybody will repopulate on the empty squares. Did I? Oops, I didn't mean to do that. And to hit building direction. I don't remember if I told it to seal the layer or not. So yeah, we have this one left up here, so we're just going to sit here and fire at will at the red dragons as they spawn until they come over here and seal the layer. Just keep hitting Y to spam arrows on. And like I said in the previous episode, if you knock them off the map, that counts as killing them. There we go. Red dragon lair is destroyed. People want to talk to me. Once again. Sir Jeff, no one seems to be here. Could it be that those two have also had their hearts drawn away by the evil powers? Sir Jeff, you must enter the shrine and fight to save your people. So that's the indicative of them turning to the dark side, as you would say. The little black and red faces. Alright, so we gotta go back to the Sky Palace here and go down into the shrine. Again, I don't know much magic to use, so I'm gonna stick with Stardust. This is Marahna Act 2 coming up. In the shrine, or temple, whichever you want to call it. Alright, here we are. Can't go right, so we gotta go left. Got a snake dragon thing. A couple snake dragon things. Weird. Oh, hell there. Some heads that shoot out projectiles at us. Just gonna stay ducked here, basically. And I ducked right into the fireball. That was pretty dumb. Next section. Another jumping snake dragon thing. Another one. I think these platforms are gonna fall, if I remember correctly. Yep. We got an extra life there, I believe. Whoa, that was close. Must land around the spikes. That would have been bad. I don't remember which direction to go, but let's say there was two different ways I could go. The head came around with that skeleton. And they fire projectiles at me. Some more snake dragons. Getting jacked up here, man. And a Grim Reaper thing below me. Unlike Castlevania, that one only takes two hits. Much easier to kill than the one in Castlevania, that's for sure. And a blue and red thing that generates lightning bolts. Not killable. Just have to dodge it, I guess. Oops, got hit by it. Oh, thank God that was a full apple. I would have been really screwed if it wasn't. So I only had one hit left on me. Hey, where'd you come from? Snake just jumps down at me. From out of nowhere. Another dragon thing. Couple more. Another Grim Reaper. More projectile heads. Did I kill it? Alright, you can kill them. Okay, I didn't know you could do that. Good to know. These red and blue things again. Well, that was not smart. Didn't kill me, but I got hit. Next section. Which is the boss? This is like a Mega Man here with the spike platforms that fall. Yeah, very much here. Hit the boss! One more hit, there you go. Finally. Good thing I had that extra source of magic. From Aitos. Marahna Act 2, clear. Not a very high score that time, only 11,830. But that's okay, not going for high score. People want to talk to me again, as they're going to thank me, of course. Cultivating the land of Marahna was a difficult task for us. No matter how many homes we seemed to build, monsters came and destroyed them. In the midst of all our troubles, a man of eloquence appeared. He assured us that by becoming the monster's followers, trouble and hardship would be eliminated from our lives. Alas, we were deceived by his words. I realized how susceptible human beings are. All of us learned a very important lesson from this experience. We will never betray you again. We can now carry on without your help. Please help other lands find the peace we now have in Marahna. I think there's something to do with this Eagle Island over here, but I'm not sure what that is. So we're going to bail out the rest of the roads here in Marahna, and then move on. So you gotta wait for it to catch up to where you want to go if you can't go that far, because once you go a certain distance it will stop going, as you saw there. If you try to do the build direction again before it catches up to you, it will just go back to where you left off. So it's kind of pointless to do so. We got one more path across the bridge here to do. And there we go. Oops. There we go. All our paths or roads, whatever you want to call them, have been built. Of course, we don't have the population here, so we're gonna let this run a little bit until we get the next level, at least. Just 2,900 people, if I recall correctly. So we can need about 100 more people, 108 to be exact, before we get our next level. There's plenty of room left for population. Since we wiped out the whole island with the earthquake earlier. Whoops. But didn't have a choice, had to do that to proceed. As I mentioned. Alright, less than 100 now. 68, I think. That's how many we need to level. So basically your population counts as experience in this game. We need 28 more people. Just flying around, waiting for it to trigger the level. This should probably do it. Yep. Level up. We are now level 13 and we have 20 hit points. We'll get another level when we have 3,300 people. Alrighty. Do we have any offerings you need to take? Oh yes, we got a bomb and an herb. Oh yes, we would like the herb. My master, this is a medical herb. Anyone who drinks the tea of this herb will be immediately cured of any plague. Alrighty, moving along. Can't remember, did anyone have a plague? What is Casadora unhappy about? Yep, this is where we need it. My master, too many of our people are dying of the plague. It is terrible to see so many suffer, wither, and die. Please give us some herbs. Please save us from suffering and bring peace to our lives. Well, you're in luck, Casadora, because I have some herbs. Get out the herbs. Where are they? There they are. With this, the people will no longer be afflicted with the plague. There you go, Casadora. Have some herbs. Don't say I never gave you anything, Casadora. Oops, wrong button. I'm gonna let it build out the rest of the roads here while I'm here. Shouldn't take too much longer. We got a couple more to build there, and like one or two over here, maybe some over here. That'll take very long. One right here too, one or two. Come on, hurry up and build. They didn't even say thanks for curing them of the plague. What ungrateful people. I should just use the earthquake and destroy them all. And that'll teach them. Ungrateful old punks. Save your lives and they don't even want to talk to me. But now they do. About time. We found an ancient tablet under the rock at the ancient ground drawing. The tablet says something about an island that is the same shape as the ground drawing. We present this tablet to you. Please accept it. Hint, hint, hint. That is referring, of course, to the island and Marahna, which we just saw a few minutes ago. Now we need to get the tablet from them. I thought there was something with the drone. Take the bomb, of course. Get that while we're here. Might as well. We have too many passions. You cannot carry any more without giving one up. How the heck do I do that? Alright, that's fine. Let's use a bomb. We already had two anyway. Didn't need any. Another one. Alright, now we're gonna take the ancient tablet. It mentions something about a bird-shaped island. If this is given to people living on such an island, you may become enlightened. So we gotta take that back to Marahna. Obviously. Really? One person? That's all you can afford to give me? One person? Alright, gotta start build direction again here. Now they want to talk to me again. Oh, Master, we found a strange scroll at the foot of the mountain just south of here. We present this to you as an offering. Please accept it. Source of magic, probably. This will only benefit those lands who rely on fishing for a living. What so happens if you try to use the compass? Dang it, I did not mean to do it again. Hit the button too many times. Kinda dumb, it won't let you take the source of magic if you have full offerings, even though the source of magic doesn't count in your offerings. Look at that, they built the road around the tree. That's pretty funny. Stop giving me just one person, I mean, come on. What's wrong with this picture? Why is no one coming out of here? Are you gonna build a road through the mountain too? We're just gonna sit there and blink forever. How'd that go away? It just randomly despawned. That's weird. There's another one. What's happening to those? Why are they disappearing? Very strange. Maybe the people that live there died? I don't know. Is that possible? I have no idea. Hurry up. It's taking forever. I don't think it's gonna take this long. Still gotta do Northwall, at least part of it. Alright, I finally finished all that. Just trying to build the rest of the roads here. To empty houses, or lots, I guess, for lack of a better term. I think that was the last one we had to do. Not one more. There we go. That is all the... Oh wait, there's one more. Dang it. Don't think we can do that one, but I'm gonna check it. Just in case. Nope, doesn't look like he can. Try one more time from the other direction. Yep, that's it. All right, back to the Sky Palace and back to Marahna. So you can use the tablet here and find out what's up with the bird island. That island has to be here somewhere. Let's give the tablet to the people and see what will happen. Now they want to talk to me. They got a boat up there, as you can see. Oh, Master, an ancient tablet has fallen from the sky. As instructed by this tablet, we shall investigate the bird-shaped island. They go, they're walking out there to the boat to board it to go to the bird-shaped island. There they go, setting sail for the bird-shaped island. Magically, the boat can dock at shore. It doesn't have to dock at a dock. I guess it's not a very big boat. They didn't even close to the shore. I mean, look at that. It's still in the water. You say it swam to shore. And they're walking through trees. Hurry up and investigate. Tell me what's going on so we can move on to Northwall. Guess they're not capable of telling me what's going on until they get back. Maybe it's the only people that were in the temple there, shrine, whatever you want to call it, our base. And they're back. And they're taking their sweet time going back to the our base here. Yay, we're gonna go back inside. You gonna talk to me now or what? What's the deal? I know it's unexpected, but our people want to talk to you. No, it's not unexpected. I expected it. Let's give these people some wheat. They don't have any. And use the compass on them so they can navigate the open seas, too. There you go, have some wheat. Come on, talk to me. Give me whatever you're going to give me from the bird island so I can move on, please. People out there in the fields. There we go, finally. Regrettably, my master, nothing has been found on the island or east of here. I'm certain there is something hidden there, but the dense bushes make it difficult to search the island. However, we have not given up. We will continue to search the island. Maybe I can burn them with lightning? Let's try it. Let's see. I took out one of them. Are they gonna go back to the island or just gonna sit here and not do anything? So that's all I can destroy. There they go, they're going back now, finally. Now hurry up, people. Chop chop, ain't got all day. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do. Go faster, boat. These people need to invest in some speedboats, man. What kind of civilization do they call themselves? They want speedboats. That's probably where the, whatever we were looking for is buried right there. That empty square, I'm guessing. Go, go, go. Hey, we found something. Hey, we found something. Alright, go back to the ship. Guess I should be doing building direction here too. While I'm thinking about it. Build, build, build. I think there's a couple paths that I still need to construct. Roads, whatever you want to call them. Maybe not, though. I don't know. No, I guess not. There's features in the way that prevent me from doing so. I'll go down to the southeastern corner as well. Check that. I know that's unexpected, but people want to talk to you. It's not unexpected when I know that they're going to do it. Come on. Give me whatever you found. Chop chop, I think all day. We can't trigger it ourselves, we just have to wait, basically, as far as I know. There we go. My master, we have discovered the master's magic on the island northeast of here. We present this to you as an offering. Please accept it. Now talk to me again. Oh, master, we have started deep sea fishing here in Marahna. The ocean can yield many strange and wonderful things. We'll inform you if something unusual is found. Let's take whatever they found here. Magical aura. The scroll must belong to you, my master. Please accept it as an offering. I think that's a protective spell, if I remember correctly. Alright, well, we're done in Marahna. And they said, go north, young man, go north. And that is what we are going to do. Northwall, to be precise. I'm going to save it here, since we've done quite a bit. And we're going to finish up here doing Act 1 of Northwall, most likely. Might do a little simulation as well, depends on the time it takes us to Act 1. So here we go, Act 1 of Northwall coming up. Northwall being the winter snow ice place, of course. And here we are. A bird dropping an egg or a rock or something else. Giant guy throwing axes, I guess that is. That was a shield. That's for axes, I don't know. Can't really tell. Spikes. Gargoyle statue. Bird again. More spikes. Whoa. Good thing I got hit there, because that would have been death, probably. Since I got knocked into the spikes. Source of magic. Use icebox break, if I remember correctly. Or fall, anyway. Could really use an apple right about now. Of course, it's not going to give me one, because that would make too much sense. More spikes. Eyeball thing. Wow, I barely made that jump. Please be an apple. No, points. I don't want points. I want a frickin' apple. I don't know which way I'm supposed to go. Hopefully this is an apple over here. Yes, thank God. Full apple. That's what I like to see. Alright. Now I have to go right. Icicle is falling down. Oh, missed that jump up. Hey, there's a 1-up down here. Floating these ice cubes here. Come back, ice cube. I'm gonna sit here and wait for you. Dang it, missed it again. Thought I was gonna come all the way left, and it did not do so. There we go. Kill the bat. Got a duck here, so you don't get hit by the spikes. Oh, barely made that jump. Another eyeball thing. There's a platform here that speeds along. Dang it. Gotta get back on it here. Platform. And not get hit by the eyeballs, preferably. Dang it, platform, come here. Cooperate. There we go. Jump! There we go. Nice. Getting jacked up by the axe guy. Stop hitting me. Half apple. And another 1-up. Nice. 5 extra lives now. The platform is really hard to jump on. I guess you're just supposed to go back over here to the stationary platforms and wait for it to land on you. Like so. Dang it. Eyeballs, don't be hitting me. What do I ever do to you? Another crown there, so 1,000 points. Bomb there to destroy everything. But there's nothing on the screen at the time, so it didn't really help very much. More bats. Another axe guy. Another axe guy. And some gargoyle statues. Put your shield down. I'm trying to hit you. More eyeballs. Dang it. There we go. Got something right here. What is this? Source of magic. I got hit by an axe while trying to get it. Alright, didn't want to jump all the way down, but that's okay. There we go. Take out the axe guy. And the statue. And I fell. Hey, why'd that guy come back? Killed him already. How does he block my attacks from behind when the shield is in front of him? Not sure how that's possible, but okay. Don't know if I need to go left or right here. I'm gonna try left first. There's a orb statue there with a full apple. Nice. Definitely needed that. Don't be hitting me. Axe guy again, jacking me up. Drop your shield. I'm trying to hit, kill you. Come on, dude. Seriously. Finally. Boss time, I think. Yep. It's a flying person thing. Shoots out pink magic, I guess. Ball magic. I don't know what else you would call it. I mean, what else is it? Check him up with Stardust. Hit him. Or her. Whatever it is. Booyah! Bye-bye, boss. So much for you. Hey, it's 9 o'clock on the dot. Look at that. Good timing on my part. So we finished Northwall Act 1 with how many points? 17,460. That's pretty good. We didn't even use all our magic either. Okay, so this is the simulation portion of Northwall, which we're going to be saving for our next episode. Because it's 9 o'clock and that's our hour. That gives us a good starting point. And they want to talk to me immediately, of course. Oh, Master, our land Northwall is covered with snow. Please use the warmth of the sun to melt the snow. We long to see the green of the plateau. So they can't build while there's snow and ice up, so you have to use sunlight to melt it all. As you can see, we've got a blue dragon layer, a red dragon layer, and a skull layer, it looks like. Oh, two skull layers. Oh, man, that's not good. That's really not good. Okay, we're going to go back to the Sky Palace here so I can save it. Alright, so that concludes this episode of Let's Play ActRaiser on the Super Nintendo. We will be back with another episode on the 14th of April, which is next Thursday, 8 p.m. Eastern, of course. And tomorrow night, we are going to have another episode of GoldenEye 007 on the N64 at 8 p.m. Eastern. And we're going to be trying to complete the solo mission again, which I've tried like three or four times now, in three or four episodes, I should say. And I've not been able to do so. And I've tried it, you know, probably at least two dozen times. I came really close a couple times. There's one time I made it to the exit, and I didn't complete all the objectives, so it didn't count. And there's another time where I died right in front of the exit. So that sucked. But, yeah. We're going to try to do that tomorrow. So you can follow us on Facebook at facebook.com/nvideogaming or on Twitter at twitter.com/nvideogames. And you can check out our official website at nvideogames.com for Nintendo news, screenshots, trailers, and lots more good stuff from Nintendo. And once again, thanks for watching our video here, and game on!